Question 7 is tricky because it's got minus 3x. And if I've got minus an amount of the x, it's harder to work with. So the first thing I want to do is to get it to be positive x. Davao, maybe you could help us. What do we have to do first? Yeah, so I just mentioned, Davao. Can you remember what I said? So what we need to do is we need to add 3x to both sides. So we've got 12, take away 3x, equals 24. I need to get positive amounts of x. It's going to be much easier to deal with it with positive amounts of x. So if I add 3x to both sides, then I'm dealing with a positive amount of x. So on this side, I've still got 12. And on this side, I've got minus 3x plus 3x. That gives me nothing here. But on this side, I've got 24 plus 3x, or 3x plus 24. I could think of it either way around. Now, I want just the x on its own, so I'm going to take away 24 from both sides. Now, 12 take away 24. Be careful. It's going, if I go down 12, I'm at 0, and I've got to go down another 12. So this will give me minus 12 equals 3x. So my last step is I'm going to divide by 3. So that gives me x on this side, and 12 divided by 3 gives me, minus 12 divided by 3 gives me minus 4. So x is equal to minus 4. Question 8. Solve the equation x divided by 2 plus 7 equals 10. So I need to think about the kind of the way in which this is set up. So it's x divided by 2 plus 7 equals 10. Well, I need to get x on its own. The first thing I'm going to do is I can't multiply both sides by 2 easily, not without multiplying this by 2 as well. So the first thing I'm going to do is take away 7 from both sides. This gives me x divided by 2 equals 3. Now to get x on its own, I'm going to times both sides by 2. So that gives me x equals 6. And that's it. Good. Question 9 requires us to put together the two skills that we've got, that you've learned, two of the skills from this topic that you've learned. So the first is to expand this bracket out and then to solve it. So if I've got 3x plus 2, actually there's two ways in which I can do this, and I'll show you both ways. Okay. The first way would be to expand it out and then solve. So I can do that. 3 times by x gives me 3x. 3 times by 2 gives me 6. And that equals 45. I've not done anything to this. I've just expanded it out. I've not multiplied or divided or added or subtracted. I've just expanded that out. So then to get x on its own, which is what we need to do to solve it, I'm going to take away 6 from both sides. That gives me 3x equals 39. And then I'm going to divide both sides by 3, and that gives me x equals 13. Now there is another way of doing that, and that's because this, so that's my answer, x equals 13. But there is a different way of doing this. This is 3 times by all of x plus 2. So I could start off by dividing both sides by 3. This gives me x plus 2 here equals 45 divided by 3, which is 15. So then all I would need to do is take away 2 from both sides. And that gives me x equals 13. So either way gets to the same answer. Question 10. Form an expression for the perimeter of the triangle. So to work out a perimeter, I need to add it all together. All the sides added together gives me my perimeter. So I've got 3p plus 2. That's this side, plus this side here, which is 3p plus 2, plus this side here, which is 2p plus 12. Now, you could put these all in brackets, these three things. I'm adding all those sides together. So let's see what that is. 3p and another 3p and 2p gives me 6, 7, 8p. And I've got 2, 4, plus 12 gives me 16. So that's perimeter. So my perimeter is 8p plus 16. Now, that's equal to 56. So I can write 8p plus 16 equals 56. And then solve it. So if 8p plus 16 is 56, I'll take away 16 from both sides. Gives me 8p equals 40. Divide both sides by 8. Gives me p equals 5.